In this episode of Theater, Storytelling in Action, we'll continue our discussion of the four spaces that make up a typical theater. In the last episode, we considered how the stage and backstage spaces served a theater. It's now time to explore the role of the house and the front of house spaces. Theaters refer to the space where the audience views the action of the play as the house. Those who purchase tickets and view the play are referred to as patrons. During the time of Shakespeare, a patron was a nobleman who took on a theater company as his personal servants. By providing patronage, the nobleman gave status to the theater company. Today's theaters still have interested members of the community who sponsor their events, but the individual who purchases a ticket is considered a patron of the play that they are viewing. The massive seating arrangement of the late theaters in ancient Greece were referred to as the theatron, which means literally the seeing place. The theatrons of this time were amazingly sophisticated and, to this day, still maintain extraordinary acoustic quality. The designs of the house space in many of today's theaters still borrow heavily from the designs of the ancient amphitheaters. In medieval theater, those viewing the action staged on the pageant wagon would stand on the ground wherever they could find a good sight line of the action. Today's houses provide seating and are designed much more carefully to provide a comfortable experience that puts the dramatic action in its best light. The house in a theater may take many different formations. Most are designed for improved comfort and visibility. Most theaters rake the seats of their house. A raked house has each row of seats elevated from the one in front of it so that the patrons in each row view the action unobstructed over the heads of those sitting in front of them. The design of a house should provide clear sight lines. Good sight lines assure that each member of the audience will have a clear view of the action of the stage. Good sight lines are also the concern of a set designer who takes the sight lines of the house into consideration when the floor plan for the set is created. Even though lighting and sound are managed by those individuals we spoke of when we address the backstage personnel, there are typically lighting positions located over the house to get the best light coverage on the stage. The lighting and sound cues are often controlled from the rear of the house. This bird's eye view of the stage gives the light and sound board operators the best vantage for timing the cues. There are some sound designers who prefer to operate the sound board in the house itself so that they may hear the same levels of sound as does the audience. The member of the theater company who typically is in charge of the house is the house manager. The house manager serves as a liaison between the activities in the house and those that occur within the front of house, which we'll discuss a little later. The house manager also serves as the liaison with the stage manager to coordinate the beginning of the play. The house manager oversees the activities of the ushers. This is the group of personnel whose task it is to get everyone to their assigned seats before curtain time. Enhancing the audience's experience with the play is the goal of the fourth of the theater spaces, the front of house. As we said in the last episode, the plays of the medieval theater took place at religious festivals where the atmosphere was like that of a fair. As the audience moved from pageant wagon to view the plays, they would encounter jugglers and singers who heightened the festival ambiance. As you could imagine, there would also be people selling food and drinks. All of this creates what the front of house personnel referred to as a sense of occasion. A professional theater understands that while a play begins when the curtain goes up, the patrons experience the play the minute that they walk into the theater. The area that makes up this initial space in the front of the house is referred to as the lobby. How the lobby is designed and what makes up a specific theater's front-of-house activities play a large role in the identity of the theater. Many theaters boast a grand lobby that sets the tone for the play that their patrons are about to see. Other theaters front their houses with a more rustic lobby to create a gritty and approachable theater. On a practical level, the front of house is where the tickets are sold. The box office manager oversees these activities. Concessions, if there are any, are sold in the lobby. Some lobbies provide a bar for their patrons. It's traditional in theater to open the front of house early and then open the house precisely 30 minutes before curtain time. This further emphasizes the sense of occasion that a theater hopes to create. So the four theater spaces in a typical theater are the stage, the backstage, the house, and the front of house. As we have said, the specific arrangement of these spaces in any theater determines the identity of that theater. Perhaps the most important physical arrangements in a theater is the relationship between the stage and the house. This can be arranged any number of ways. However, there are three spaces that are traditional to theater today: the proscenium space, the thrust space, and the arena, or theater in the round space. We'll take a careful look at these arrangements and how they affect the action of the stage in the next episode of Theater, Storytelling in Action. We'll catch you on the other side.